It's a grand old flag, it's a high. Hello and welcome to the Sturt season preview. My name's Zach Milbank and joining me today is Sturt coach Seamus Maloney. And Seamus, obviously you're one of just three SANFL coaches to remain in the job this year. You must be pleased that I guess you've got that from a stability point of view.
Yeah, definitely. I think the longer you're able to be at the club, the more comfortable you feel and the more you get used to the group of players you've got and the future of the club. So, yeah, I think it's great to have some stability.
It must have been wrapped that obviously the club had a show of faith in you and extended your contract that extra year into this year, and no doubt be pushing up trying to make the finals this season.
Yeah, no doubt. It is. It was great to get an extra year on the contract. I think the club's at a really good spot to attack 2014. It's an exciting year for the club with the changes to the competition, so it's a year that I was really excited to be involved in.
You touched on those changes to the competition. Obviously a major one of those is the new Adelaide Crows team. Obviously that affects you quite significantly because you had a number of those Crows listed players with you last year. How do you go about, I guess, dealing with that this season?
Oh, look, it's all positive. It's definitely where the club that's probably been affected as much as anyone. And we had lots of good, talented players playing with us from the Adelaide Crows and a little bit of Port Power, but mainly the Adelaide Crows the last few years. So we've had to recruit pretty hard. Mm-hmm. We've had to really analyse our list of our young guys and who mm-hmm. we see playing good quality league footy, and put a lot of time into those guys through this pre-season. And for us, we're really excited as a whole club, a playing group and coaching group. I think knowing that pre-season from day one was all about finding our side for round one, and sure, all the players are very competitive and really enjoying that challenge, knowing that we're not getting to that point and having other players come back in. So mm-hmm. no, it's been a really exciting pre-season. Everyone's really ready for it.
I'm glad you mentioned the younger guys then. Can you, I guess, enlighten Sturt fans as to who's really impressed you on the track and might push up and play some league footy this year?
Yeah, we've got a few guys who probably made the names a bit last year and over the last year or two, of guys like Paige, Harms, Stevens, Fraser Evans, John Greenslade, guys like that who have been around a little bit, and I expect those guys to take their footy to another level.
Yep.
And I think and there's quite a few others that are in that group that are really important for Sturt, and mm-hmm. we need those guys playing really well.
Yep.
There's some younger guys who haven't played yet, like Paddy Wilson, Jack Penfold, Jared Leanett. There's quite a few guys who come out of our under-18 system that are really talented players, mm-hmm. and will get a taste of footy some earlier, some later this year, but I expect them to be really good players in the club.
You touched on recruiting, your recruiting drive over summer, obviously a little bit more aggressive than usual. Landed a couple of other guys who will feature in this video in Richard Tambling and Rory Taggart, but also a trio of Magpies in Corey Beard, Zane Kirkwood and also James Watt.
Yeah, very happy about that. We went hard for the three Port boys. We mm-hmm. identified that from mid to late last year, so we made a real clear target of the ones we wanted, and we hunted pretty hard as a group, and luckily for us it's come off, and we've got three great blokes, really talented footballers and mm-hmm. guys who are really setting great standards around the place. So unfortunately for James, he had a wrist injury through training and is still in plaster, but he'd be close for round one selection. Yep. But the other two guys from Port have been training the house down, and they're all going to have a big impact. Getting Richard Tambling back's fantastic. Mm-hmm. He's played some great footy with us, but to have him around the place full time is awesome. And Rory Taggart's another we got from Melbourne, who is a really talented young player, and we see him having a great future with the club.
Now, of course, before I let you go, we're standing here in lovely new premises of Claridge Holden here on Unley Road, big sponsors of the footy club for a long time, and no doubt the club would be lost without them.
Yeah, they've been fantastic supporters, Claridge Holden, with Mike and Wayne and the guys here. Mm-hmm. They've got the brand new showroom, which just opened in December. So it's an awesome facility.
Yeah.
It's showing off the nice Holden's well. So yeah, invite everyone to get down and have a look, especially Sturt supporters. They'll look after them.
Certainly will, no doubt about that. And Sturt supporters will be extremely keen to see how you're faring this year. Seamus, thank you very much for joining us on your season preview.
Thanks, Zach.
Joining me now is Sturt recruit Rory Taggart. And Rory, obviously sporting a plaster there on your wrist. Can you enlighten Sturt fans as to how you're tracking?
I'm coming along really well. Spoke to the surgeon yesterday and got a new cast put on. He was very happy with how the surgery went. Mm-hmm. Felt good when I had it out of the plaster for a bit. So another 4 weeks in this one.
Yeah.
And then hopefully I can get back as quick as I can.
You're hopeful of being right for round one, or how's that faring?
Well, they did say 3 months initially from the from the surgery, so that'll look about round five.
But okay.
I'll push as hard as I can to get back as quick as I can.
Have you settled into the Adelaide way of life and more specifically training with the Double Blues?
Yeah, really well. The club's been great for me so far. It's a nice young group. I've gotten along with everyone really well. The coaches and everyone involved has been great. The Adelaide lifestyle's pretty good. It's nice and a bit cruisier than Melbourne, so it's a bit easier to get around. And it's all going very well, so I'm happy with the move.
Terrific. Obviously touched on Melbourne there. You played for the Melbourne Footy Club and were on the list there as well. Tell us about what you learned through your time there with the Demons.
Well, a lot of it, I had a fair few injuries in my time there, so a lot about managing my body and I guess learning all the right things to do as far as recovery and diet. But then just the list that was around there as well, like some great players in old Double Blue, Jack Trangove and Nathan Jones and Jack Grimes. Like, they're great guys to learn off. They're only young as well, but the stuff they taught me in my short time there was hopefully a lot of things I can bring to this club and teach some younger guys coming up as well.
So for Sturt fans who haven't seen you play yet, how would you describe yourself as a player?
Probably say a big-bodied midfielder. Like, say my kicks being something I've been recognised in the past. So pretty strong right foot kick, strong overhead. But I guess the rest of it they'll have to be the judge of.
No doubt they're extremely keen to see you in action this year. Hopefully it's sooner rather than later with that wrist injury. But all the best in season 2014, Rory. We thank you for having you on.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Joining me now is star Sturt recruit Richard Tambling, and Richard, obviously very familiar with your SANFL club, so it was probably no doubt an easy transition for you to make.
Yeah, definitely. Look, coming to the end of my AFL career, it was a question of where I wanted to go, and it was either stay here in Adelaide or move back to Darwin. There was no issue with any other SANFL clubs, so I see myself as a Double Blue now. It's in my blood, so. Yeah, it was only one place I was going, really.
What is it that you like most about the Sturt Footy Club and that really, I guess, had that hold on you to stay?
Yeah, look, I guess history behind the club's very, very good. You walk into the change rooms and you look up and there's photos everywhere of the history of the club. Great people around the club. They've helped me since day one. They've made me feel very welcome. And, rain or shine, everyone's always at games, and we've got supporters that are very loyal to the club, and they're there every week.
Obviously you got a lot of experience throughout your fantastic AFL career with the Richmond Tigers and the Adelaide Crows. No doubt like to play a bit of a mentoring role for some of the youngsters coming through.
Oh, definitely. Look, I don't have a title at the club. I just sort of, lend a hand where I can and help out where I can, whether that be the younger players or just anyone in general. I don't mind a chat, and I'm usually around the club, so just hand out wherever.
Obviously, towards the end there at the Crows, you're playing as a sort of like a running halfback type role. Do you sort of see yourself playing more in the midfield with the Double Blues this year?
Yeah, I think so. Most of the preseason, I've been training as a midfielder, but I can swing anywhere the coach needs me. Pretty much early on, I played as a forward, so I don't mind kicking a goal myself. But there haven't been too many of those in the last couple of years.
Well, no doubt Sturt fans will want to see plenty of those this year. And one other thing they'd like to see is you guys playing finals, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Look, I I've just managed to play my first final in my whole senior career on the weekend with my club back in Darwin, and I'd like to have another one this year. So it'd be good to give the supporters something to cheer about during the year. We obviously haven't gone very well over the last couple of years, but we have been young and developing, and hopefully those guys can now step up and we can make the finals.
Tell us a little bit about more how you fared up there in Darwin and your club, and I guess it no doubt keeps you in good shape over the off season.
Yeah, definitely. I managed to play 7 games back up there for the Southern Districts Crocodiles, my junior club I haven't played for 10 years, so it was great to get back, play with some old mates, and you know, play under a guy that pretty much mentored me as a kid coming up, so he's a coach out there, so it was good. Unfortunately, we fell over on the weekend in the Elim final, so you know, good luck to the other teams that are trying to get in the granny.
Well, hopefully the script doesn't follow at the Sturt Footy Club this year. Richard, we thank you very much for joining us on your season preview video and wish you all the best.
No worries, thank you.
Cheers.